Good morning everyone, my name is Vishwas. Today we are going to learn or move further in chapter light of class 10, right? So in this chapter now we are going to start with spherical lenses, which is our next topic. If you have not seen the previous videos, you have to see the previous video in order to understand about this topic, that is we call as spherical mirrors. So let's start with our topic, spherical mirrors. A transparent medium bounded by two surfaces of which one or both surfaces are curved means, like we have already understood about spherical mirrors, and this is basically spherical lenses. So what is the difference between mirror and lens? First of all, the basic difference between mirror and lenses, in case of mirror there is a polished surface, right, and reflection takes place in that. That means if the light strikes the mirror, it will go back in the same medium. But when we talk about lenses, when the light or a ray of light strikes the lens surface, it will just move or change its medium from one medium to another, or rarer to denser. It can be denser to rarer also. That means there will be a change in medium in case of lenses, right? So lenses are basically of many kinds. Basically two we are going to this chapter, that is convex and concave. One is bifocal lens also, that is made up of both the lenses, convex and concave lens, that we will study later on. So convex and concave lens, how they appear. See this is basically the shapes that we are going to study about. This is a convex lens, we call it convex also. This is a concave lens, which we call as biconcave also. Like I have taught you one concept regarding CNC, right? Do shaitan bache, and here it's called one shaitan bache, right? Because single C come in case of convex and double C comes in case of concave. So similarly, the same thing that I have told you in the previous video, jahan pe do shaitan bache honge, wo kahan jayenge? Class ke bahar. तो आप इसकी अगर शेप देख रहे होंगे कॉनकेव लेंस की, तो ये कहां है? बल्ज्ड आउट है, राइट, बाहर की तरफ है. एंड व्हेन यू विल सी कन्वेक्स, ये अंदर की तरफ बेंड होता है, राइट. सो एक शैतान बच्चा तो क्लास के अंदर रहेगा, एंड इफ देयर विल बी टू शैतान बच्चे देन इट विल गो आउटसाइड द क्लास, राइट, बिकॉज़ दे वोंट अलाउ अदर क्लास स्टूडेंट्स टू स्टडी इन देयर क्लासरूम. सो इट्स बेटर फॉर द टीचर टू मेक देम आउट, राइट. So it's a very simple day-to-day life example you can learn with. This is plano convex, this is plano concave. Why we call it plano? Because one surface of this lens is plane, and this lens is also plane. And this is meniscus. This is not in your syllabus, so, but you should be knowing about such kind of shapes. Important terms related to the spherical lenses. Pole. The midpoint of the symmetric center of a spherical lens known as its optical center, and it is also known as pole in case of mirrors, right? You can call it pole in this also, but we have to write according to the entity, so we have to write as optical center, that is O, right? Okay, principal axis, the line passing through the optical center and the center of curvature, that's same for both. Paraxial ray, the ray close to principal axis and also parallel to it. Now this is a kind of ray which is parallel to the principal axis and close to the principal axis, and this is center of curvature, that's the same, the center of that the spherical lens was a part of, or can be written like the center of the sphere of which there is a part. That will be a simple definition. I am repeating, the center of the sphere of which mirror is a part. Next. Now we came up to the definition of focal length. So what is focal length? Distance between optical center and the principal focus is basically known as focal length. Concave lens. What's concave lens? Concave lens is basically called as diverging lens. As you can observe in the previous figure that I have shown you today in this video only, that it used to diverge the images or diverge the rays, light rays that is getting refracted from it, right? And convex lens is basically called as converging lens because all the rays which is falling on the converging lens or convex lens, they are going to concentrate over a particular point after refraction from the lens. And these certain rules for deformation by convex lens. A ray of light parallel to principal axis of a convex lens always pass through the focus on the other side of the lens. What does that mean? That means whenever a ray of light, let us stand by this figure, this is the ray of light which is parallel to the principal axis, right? So this arrow is showing the direction of the ray of light. When it strikes the lens, this line where it is getting intersecting with the principal axis line is known as the optical center. This is focus, principal focus, and 2F1 is basically called the center of curvature. In case of lenses, you will denote all these things by 2F1 and 2F2, not by C. You can represent by C, but as we have to follow the NCERT CBSE instructions, so it's 2F1 and 2F2. In this case, as you can observe, focus is on both the sides and center of curvature is on both the sides. Why is it? Because as you can see, there are two surfaces. One is this one, and if we will extend the surface in the dotted form, from here to here, what will happen? There will be one C for this surface, that is here, and one focus for this surface, right? But when you will see this surface, then there should also be one center of curvature for this and one focus for this, right? A ray of light passing through the focus will emerge parallel to the principal axis after refraction. So in that case, as you can see, the ray of light which is parallel to the principal axis will meet at focus, as we have already discussed in case of mirrors also. So the focus is on the both the sides, but in case of lenses, refraction takes place, so image will be formed on the other side, right? So in this case, as you can see, when the ray of light is passing through the focus, when the object is kept at the focus, the image is formed at infinity, right? So again, I am repeating, when the object is kept at focus or the ray of light is coming from focus, that ray of light will go and form image at infinity. Now, next is this. When the ray of light is passing through the optical center, that is known as O, what will happen in that case? In that case, the ray of light goes straight out the kind of reflection. Now, ray diagram of the image formed by convex lens. When the object is at infinity, let's see the issue first. Here in this case, the rays are coming from infinity as the object is placed at infinity far away. And all these rays, as you can see, are parallel to the principal axis. When these rays are parallel to the principal axis, refracts from the mirror or refracts from the lens, then what will happen? In that case, all the rays get converged at a particular point that is known as F2, and we call it focus of the mirror also, right? So here the image will be formed, and the image, as you can see, it's quite point sized image. So in this case, let's see, the nature of the image is real and inverted, and the point size or diminished image is formed over here. So in this case, you have seen this word real and inverted. But in case of mirrors, I have told you that whatever the image is formed in case of right side, that is known as virtual, and here whatever the image is formed on the right side of the mirror, that is known as the real and inverted image. Why is it so? Because in case of mirrors, backside means it's an imaginary end, right? So at the backside of the mirror, you can just imagine where the image is formed. So that's why we call it as virtual. But in this case, let's take an example. You are wearing your glasses, and in case of that glasses, what happens? Glasses means spectacles. So in case of those spectacles, you are fitted with some lenses, right? So when you are looking at a particular object, what will happen in that case? The ray of light is coming from that object, passing through the lens and getting converged or diverged in case of your eye, and image is getting formed on the retina, right? So in this case, you might have observed there is a change in medium, right? So image is getting formed at the backside because the light rays has to be passed from the lenses. In this case, it lenses, and in that case, it was mirror. Right. So in this case, the image will always be formed at the backside of the lens, that is on the other end. So that image will be called as real and inverted. Now in this case also, you will see when object is 2f1. 2f1 means beyond C, right? I have marked with C here also. So image position is between, as you can see, one ray is going parallel to the principal axis, the other ray is passing through the optical center, they are meeting. This ray is, as it is parallel, it will pass to focus, and this ray will go straight, and the image is getting formed between f1 and 2f2, right? So it's a very simple thing. Jab object pada hoga 2f1 se piche, right? So image kaam banegi f2 or 2f2 ke beech mein, on the other side. And this will be a diminished image. Diminished means point size nahi, choti image banegi, right? It will be real and inverted as well. And when the object is 2f1, the image will form that 2f2. That means a similar case as that we have done in case of mirrors, when the object is kept at C. So here also it is C only. We have denoted by 2f1. So when the object is kept at 2f1, one ray will go parallel to the principal axis, passes through the focus, and meet here with the other ray that is coming the optical center of the mirror without any kind of deviation. It goes straight, and both the rays are meeting over here at 2f2, that center of curvature 2, where the image will be formed. And this image is one of the same as that of the object. You have to draw these diagrams and understand each and every ray from where it is coming and going, depending upon the rules that I have already told you in this video. So when object is between f1 and 2f1, what happens in this case? Image position is beyond 2f2. So jab hum object thoda aage leke aa rahe hain, to aap dekh rahe hain image piche jaati ja rahi hai aur badi banti ja rahi hai. So in this case, the object is between center and focus, that is 2f and f1. So object is kept over here. I have to write b over here because of object is denoted by ab, and the image is denoted by a dash b dash. So one ray will go parallel to the principal axis, passes through the focus and go like this. And the ray will pass through the optical center of the mirror and meet the ray which is already passed on from the focus at point A dash. So here beyond 2f2, the image will be formed, that is denoted by A dash B dash. And this is, you can observe, as compared to AB, A dash B dash is quite large. So it's a enlarged image, and obviously the rear inverted. When object is at f1, image will form that infinity, that is the same opposite case. So when the object is placed at focus, one ray will pass through the optical center, and the other ray will go parallel to the principal axis, and it will pass through the another focus. As you can see, these both rays are never intersecting, they are parallel rays, so image will be formed far away, and that we call as infinity. In this case also, image is inverted and real and highly enlarged because rays are not intersecting. If the image will be formed, it's formed quite far away, and so quite an enlarged image, that's why we call as infinity. Now in this case only, today we are going to shut down our topic after this, because this is the most important ray diagram. As you can see, case of lenses also, the image sometimes will form as vertical and erect, that means on the same side. Here you can able to see the rays are going this side, but the image is not getting formed. These are intersecting rays, but the rays, if you will extend that back, then they will be intersecting, right? And in this case, it's never intersecting on the right side of the mirror, so we have to extend that rays. Imaginary image will be formed in this case. So nature of image will be virtual and direct, that's why I have called imaginary. And the size of the image, as you can see, as compared to the object, is quite enlarged. So see what is happening in this case. As we have kept the object even between optic center, that is O, and f1, so what will happen in this case? This object, one ray will go like this, parallel to the principal axis, and strikes the lens, and striking the lens, it goes pass through the focus on the other side of the lens. And one ray will pass through the optical center that goes straight without any kind of reflection. So when we used to extend this rays at the backside of the mirror, what will happen? The rays will somewhere meet over here beyond 2/1. So in this case, an imaginary image is getting formed, a virtual image is getting formed, that is denoted by a dash dash. So in order to do all these cases, what you have to do, you have to be very clear about each and every ray from where it is coming and where it is getting intersected or the image is getting formed. It's very simple, just to you have to go by rules. And if you haven't watched the previous video and you try to understand this concept, it will be a little bit difficult. So I will prefer you go and watch the previous videos that I have uploaded regarding the same concepts. So at last, I would like to say thank you. Stay safe, stay at home, and kindly update your studies regularly and learn from the videos or the other sources from whatever way you want, whatever way you like to learn, right? I will help you out. And in case of any doubts, you can contact me. Thank you and have a nice day.